Bjorn Bjerke and I think that we have found a method or a property of the Bitcoin blockchain system that allows the laundering of Bitcoins to remove all taint from them in a much more effective way than mixing. So you may wonder why I'm talking about this. Well, there's no company we can turn to announce this bug to and claim a bug bounty. It's a feature of the system, so somebody else is going to discover it eventually. So it seemed a good idea to get it out now and see if we can either fix it or maybe we just have to accept that that's the way that the system works. So in short, Bjorn came up with the method for decoupling coins from their history, and companies like Chainalysis exist out there that do forensics on the Bitcoin blockchain in order to determine the history of coins, because all the transactions are recorded, and if some coins were used to buy illicit drugs on Silk Road or were stolen from someone, then you can track them as they progress through other addresses, and then you may refuse to accept them. This makes Bitcoins not entirely fungible, because there are some Bitcoins that have a dark and shady history compared to others. So Bjorn's method relies on the observation that mining rewards decouple Bitcoins from their history. When you pay a mining reward, you don't actually pay it, you just fail to claim it and therefore allow the miner to claim it. And when that happens, the input-output links that link the transaction to transaction to transaction gets broken, because it's done by kind of summing across all unclaimed or unspent inputs of all the transactions in the block. So it kind of destroys the coins and then creates an equivalent number of new ones. And that's why I was doing the two videos earlier this week about how to destroy Bitcoins and about how rewards and transactions work. So that's the key method. So Bjorn's the mastermind behind this, of how it works. However, you have a problem, which is that how do you guarantee that you get those rewards? And that's where I came in and pointed out that when you have a transaction, you don't have to make it public. You can create a transaction. Let's say you have 10 tainted Bitcoins. You create a transaction in which you take those 10 tainted Bitcoins as an input, you spend maybe one Satoshi or nothing at all, and you leave the rest on the table as a reward for the miner. Now, you also need a miner, and that transaction is kept secret, and only your miner can mine that transaction, and eventually you find a block, and now you announce your block and the transaction at the same time, and that gives nobody else time to mine that transaction and ensures that your miner gets the reward. And that is how a criminal organization could launder their tainted Bitcoins. So anybody who has a good technical understanding of the Bitcoin blockchain and protocols, please give it some thought and let me know if what I'm talking about here actually makes sense or if there's something I've overlooked. I'll leave a link to Bjorn's article in the comments of this video as well. Look forward to seeing what feedback there is. Bye for now.